Other malware that you should be familiar with includes a rootkit, which is a set of programs and code that allows a persistent or permanent, undetectable presence on a computer. A rootkit can sanitize logs and repair timestamps, hiding actions of the hackers. A rootkit can also mask files, processes, and network connections, and enable privileged access to the computer. It also conceals installed malware. For instance, when your AV antivirus software is ready to check a location where malware is resident, the rootkit will tell the AV software, "You checked it already, and it's clean. Move on to somewhere else." Rootkits also install another piece of malware called a backdoor. After hackers exploit vulnerabilities to get into your system or network, they want to come back later with less effort. Backdoors allow hackers to do so, bypassing the normal authentication process through software left after the initial penetration. It's like breaking into a physical location and propping open a back window or a back door that isn't monitored to get back in another time. Spyware covertly monitors users' activities and reports personal user data to a third party that expects financial gain. Spyware also includes the sale of personal data, the redirecting of web activity to ad sites, and the presentation of targeted ads and pop-ups through a related piece of malware called adware. Adware automatically plays or displays advertisements or downloads promotional material. It's often bundled with a product or package, and is common in shareware, free software that might require subsequent payment after a trial run. A few years ago, McAfee, the security company, coined a new term, PUP, potentially unwanted program. Often companies will include some extra to a program that users download, which would directly fall under the spyware and adware categories. These programs used to be called Trojan horses for that very reason. However, the companies that made these programs did in fact mention the extras in the EULA, End User License Agreement. They objected to the terms Trojan horse, spyware, and adware since they weren't hiding anything. But think about it. How many users actually read those EULAs? Not much. For that reason, and to avoid any legal issues, the term PUP, potentially unwanted program, was coined as a lesser way of saying Trojan horse that includes spyware and adware with your download.